as you can see, I'm using somebody's jump shot that I literally just copied from on Twitch. Now, I'm not going to show you guys the jump shot creator, because if I do show it to you guys and if you guys use it, it might lead into a patch. So I'm sorry about that, but we'll see how it goes.
Night after night, we're seeing the scoring prowess of Che. Has a string of 30-point games coming in. Kenny, do you think he can keep it up?
I think he can. He's been able to keep his focus throughout. I mean, how could you not believe in Che at this point?
Honestly, guys, no surprise to see Che getting 30 night after night. Particularly for me, somebody who averaged 30 a night back in 2000 without the free throws. Tough thing to do.
Che can do it. Did you call him Che? His name is Che. What are you, Jack?
Oh, I thought it was Che.
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 Che. Like
almost saying chair.
Yeah. Oh, got it. Che. Yeah. Thanks. You know I thought it was Che.
Jack.
Brian in Texas, looking majestic tonight. We're coming to you live from Dallas, Texas. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Moments away, it'll be the Sacramento Kings going up against the Dallas Mavericks at the American Airlines Center. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge is their sideline reporter. Let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for Heal.
And you can see the surge in his level of confidence lately. Just by looking at that true shooting percentage, and it's been moving straight up in the past 5 games. I think he's healing.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
De'Aaron Fox talked about his mentality on the court. Put the ball in his hands, he says, I'm going to take over the game. It doesn't have to be scoring, just always attacking. Always. Gotta be a dog. Don't back down from anyone. Kevin, I know you're a dog. Back to you.
A little intimidation factor, DA. Thanks. There should be plenty of fireworks out in the backcourt tonight in this one. Of the guards you played alongside, who is the best combination passer-scorer?
Oh, man, Kevin, you put me on the hot seat. That's a tough one. I just got to give everybody a shot.
You did it a while ago, didn't you?
Oh, man, I didn't know it was going to be a test today. I got to go with my boy Ron Strickland when I played with him at the Wizards. I think he's the best finisher ever, and he led the league in assists. My boy Jay Will, shout out to White Chocolate. He is one of the most creative players I've played with, but he can shoot it from the deep. He was a guy that liked to shoot it from Curry, man, and he can pass it. And then lastly, I'd have to, of course, go with my man Mike Bibby. Mike Bibby could do it all. So I've been blessed to play and been fortunate to play with some great scorers and combination passes in this league.
Three terrific names.
Okay.
Starters for Sacramento. Barnes and Bagley.
Why you can just pass the ball to me, Tim? You got the steal. And look what it cost us. Give me the ball.
Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Then there's Marjanovic. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr.
Yikes.
And he's way off from outside. And it's Barnes with the ball for the Sacramento Kings. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with San Antonio.
You got to give him an A for effort. Just fell a little bit short in that.
It's one of those games where home court played a big role. There might have been a different result if they were in their own building.
Now, here's Fox. Defense is right there. Shot from 12. It's rebounded by Dallas.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
Pass to Marjanovic. Oh, and that one. No question. Lord it down.
The finish was nice, but the setup was better.
Yeah, GA, the pick working to full effect before the stuff.
Yeah, coach is definitely lead. That's the execution he loves to see.
And here are the Kings now. The Mavericks making the shot. Here's Fox. A rebound by Marjanovic. Let's it go from 14. And the Mavericks get another bucket right there.
Number 5. Why are you calling me number 5?
Here in the first quarter, with about 2 minutes gone by. Here's Heal.
I thought my name is Che.
In their last game against San Antonio. against Porzingis. Lock at six. The Kings need to get off a shot here. Here's Bagley. That misses, so no good on his first attempt of the night. Coach is liking what he's seeing from his offense.
And guys, they put the defense on the defense.
For three, got him for his fourth field goal in the game on just five shots.
He's got easy to play. He's coming out top. Never an easy road.
Of course, Sacramento lost to the Lakers.
Fox looking it over. Pass to Barnes. And he can't stop the run as he misses. Fred, with all the time that Porzingis has missed, it's easy to forget just how dominant he is.
Durang!
KP is one of the few game-changing talents in our league. He can carry an offense and...
Every time Shaq, he loves him some Bull Bomb. Durang!
Here's Heald, following the score by Dallas. They get a hand on it. And it's the Mavericks. The break.
Oh, it didn't even call me a turnover.
Now, here's Fox. Defense right on him. That's tipped.
This quarter has been hit or miss for him mostly. Miss.
Here's Doncic. Bagley with the block.
They need that kind of defensive impact.
Where was that against the Lakers? Because Bagley was hurt.
To be aware of him at that end of the floor.
And there's the pass to Marjanovic. Dallas moving the ball around. Doncic finds Hardaway. Six to shoot. Back to Doncic. Releases. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
He makes a lot more of those than he misses. Not sure what threw him off right there.
Here's Fox. The shot will not fall. And the Mavericks going the other way now. This game against Sacramento is the first time they've met this year.
And this game, just the first of four meetings between these two. They'll get quite familiar with each other by season's end. I look forward to seeing
your rang. What?
The style of play. I mean, that's going to set the tone for this entire series.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offense.
Over two of us.
Sure. In the mid-range game.
Buddy Buckets.
Excellent. Always got to play up on him. He has the ball.
To Marjanovic. Now, here's Doncic. Deadman defending. Doncic kicks the Hardaway.
Oh, yikes! Bagley's already got two blocks.
Here's Marjanovic. 17 points for him last game against New Orleans. Clock is at three. From deep.
Damn it.
24 second violation. And a chance here now to look at the rookie race. Never too soon to see how some of the fresh faces.
Sorry, Zion. Sorry, Ja. Taking that spot.
Looking to put their name in the front of the rookie of the year race. What a rookie year he's having, guys, atop the rankings right now. And even though it might be a tight call, he's definitely
feeling right now for him.
Dude, Ja's doing so good for the Grizzlies. He's had a game winner. And 2K actually updated his rating. He's now an 81. He's tied with Zion.
He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve.
Bounce pass for Porzingis. On the wing, Doncic. Covered by Barnes. And Doncic gets it to go.
And guys, the intelligence is evident. When the pick comes, Doncic often makes the right read.
Outside, Fox. Floats one up.
I'm shutting him down, De'Aaron Fox.
Marjanovic has got his sixth rebound on the night.
You know what a kind of competitor he is? I know he's upset with his performance and with his score.
Now, here's Doncic. 8 points his last outing. Here's Porzingis. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Here's Dallas. They're on a 15-4 run right now. On the wing.
Oh, good look.
Grabs the miss.
Not sure.
I do have difficult shots, but it's on bronze.
A great
After this game, I might have to get it on silver. How does it get that game against the Lakers? They get... At first, I thought it was going to be deja vu, like what happened the last time we faced the Kings. It was going to be a buzzer beater from Bogdanovich. But that didn't happen. They didn't give the ball to Bogdanovich. They didn't even give it to Buddy Hield. Out of all the... You give the ball to, you give it to Barnes. And what happens? He paid the price. He got blocked by AD. The bench is in.
And some changes here for the Mavericks. Dwight Powell's checked in for Marjanovic. Maxi Kleba comes in for Porzingis. And it's right in for Tim Hardaway Jr.
Marjanovic, that's 3 second violation.
Let's use this break in the action to show you the teams that in the last 10 games have been the NBA's best fast.
Hey, we're number one.
The Mavericks number one.
I mean, no doubt for me that they've hit their stride the last few weeks. I mean, they are punishing the defenses with that up-tempo style.
Bogdanovich against Wright. Inside, shot from 12. Got it, number 7 on the night. 7 for 11 from the floor.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Hooked away. Here's Farrell, taking a look at his numbers. He averages about 7 points a game. Bogdanovich, no luck. That's great. Dallas goes up, and he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, they've been very aggressive, and they've taken early control of this game.
Here's Farrell.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such
Luka in the corner.
Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how
this is getting triple doubles. I wish my Luka and my career would do that.
After Luka Doncic hitting the three.
He's also 2K updated his rating to 90.
Plays it up and banks it in.
Outstanding at taking it to the cup. Now look, when Bogdanovich is in attack mode, it's great to watch.
Pass to Powell. Right outside.
Ah, that's a good look.
Rebounded by Holmes. The Kings trail by 11.
Oh, great defense on my end. Oh, never mind.
And here is Wright. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Let's it go from deep. Down and drops through the net for his ninth bucket. He is 9 for 13 so far.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Here's Farrell. Denied for the third time. He's 0 for 3. Hits the rim with a
takeover
slam.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
Yeah, we've got to be careful. It's still early. They've expended a lot of energy, but they've also built a nice...
Damn it. Oh, they're going to put me on the bench? I'm going to have takeover? I have team takeover, coach. Come on. And look what happened.
You competed with that you feel is underrated by history has not been given their due.
Coach is like, no, we've seen enough of that. You're getting a rest, but look what happened. We have a big lead, but I would have used my takeover. Team takeover.
Look at Ben Wallace, who I played with 4 years at Washington. And he was coming off the bench there. We saw that potential with him. I mean, the way he led the league and rebounding, his defensive prowess. I mean, the Pistons wouldn't have had a championship and gotten to another final if it wasn't for him. And also, I got to shout my man out.
Bagley is just destroying people. Viking did it against the Lakers, but now he got hurt.
On the court right now for the Kings, Barnes at power forward with Bagley in the middle. De'Aaron Fox out there with Farrell, and it's Heel in at the three spot. The Kings trail by 21. Nobody near Barnes. That one's good. Maybe that'll get him going after a 2-for-6 start.
Throughout his career, Barnes has been a consistent three-point shooter. I mean, that's a nice little triple right there.
Lots of room. And Dallas again with the bucket.
Long two.
He really got his defender on his heels on that one. What a fantastic play, guys.
I've literally almost outscored them in the first half.
Well, Kevin, after years and years of rebuilding, the Kings are finally a team on the rise, and they're earning respect. Draymond Green said, they've got a lot of young talent, never quit. Probably the fastest team in the history of the NBA. Green said after he plays them, I leave the game exhausted. I go home, I'm dead. And Kevin, we know that Green is pretty accustomed to going all out.
David, he sure is. He's got a lot of engine in him. Thank you so much. Heald with the bucket.
Love the confidence from Heald. He likes going to the floater when the D is giving him room to shoot.
Correa against Fox. Some nice passing here by Dallas. To the paint. Out to Doncic.
Oh, he's getting blocked again. Yaren!
And that one's good. Marjanovic. Marjanovic has got his second bucket of the night.
Yaren.
Second chance points always hurt.
Sound like I'm saying Yaren? Like Yaren the phone.
Because you did the job defensively to get the stop, and then you gave it right back.
Now here's Heald. 9 points in the game so far. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Marjanovic has got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
And how about filling out 7? I mean, instead of being lazy with the shot selection, they go right to the rim.
There's Bagley. 11 points for him in that last game against the Spurs in San Antonio.
And his impact wasn't just on offense. He played great deep.
I've got 30. I've literally outscored them.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
To the left side wing. Here's Farrell. A terrific shot on the turnaround. Correa with an 11-point game for him in the win against New Orleans. On the wing. A rebound by Heald. Heald's got his 5th rebound in this one. Here's Farrell.
He got that?
His second bucket in 5 tries. Dallas leading by 22. Pass to Porzingis. Makes it off the glass. Porzingis, he's got his first basket.
Oh, that was KP's first basket.
I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Now, here's Fox. He has 7. Heel dishes to Bagley. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Fox. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And Dallas gets called for the foul.
Well, that's what you want to do. Fox forces the defender to commit, gets him in a tough spot, and gets the trip to the line. Well, the improvement we saw from Fox was a big reason the Kings were a surprise team from last season. He emerged as one of the team leaders early on, and he is still the playmaker for this team going forward.
Here's Porzingis. And the dunk by Porzingis.
That's some skill on that assist. I mean, the timing has to be perfect on a lead pass.
Sacramento's gotten both of their 3-point attempts to go down here in the second quarter.
Next person is when he went back to New York, he got booed.
Fox against Berea.
I mean, let's be real, he didn't do anything wrong.
With Fox leading with his playmaking, the difference was clear.
Where's the foul?
So much during his rookie season. I mean, how he sees the court, when he's going to attack. The results showed up both in assist totals as well as his efficiency. But he was the one taking the shot.
Now, here's Fox. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against San Antonio, and Boban Marjanovic picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Heald. Five Packers from 14, and no good. Now Dallas takes it the other way.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the board has been impressive. And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
Oh, I do too, Greg. You have to go to your best scores. I mean, it's a smart strategy, and so far, it's paying.
He ran out of bounds.
Take possession.
Story of their game right here. One sloppy play after another.
Whitey's checked in for J.J. Barea.
Ooh. I got difficult shots on bronze.
He's played a huge role and has them in position to grab the W.
54 seconds left in the second quarter. Here's Heald, buried from 15 feet out.
I'm going to outscore them in the first half.
Masterful ball control right there from Hill. Effective at slicing through the defense and getting where he wants to go.
Outside, Porzingis.
Nerang.
Nice work on the board. It's paying off with the basket. Marjanovic has got his third basket.
Dude, we're up by 30. Is this pro difficulty?
There's that passion of his, battling with every ounce of energy he has.
Look at my guy. He's flopping.
But at this stage of his career, Barnes knows who he is. He's a glue guy who does a bit of everything.
The Kings have made two, and this two with the Lions tonight.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice
play. I'm not
going
to outscore them.
Your offense going.
Maxi Kleba, he's checked in for Marjanovic. And then for Sacramento. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Marvin Bagley. Iowitza comes in for Buddy Hield. And it's Bogdan Bogdanovic in for Fox. The pass to Porzingis. A three-pointer is right on target. Porzingis has got seven.
I don't think we'll ever see another 7 foot three player who can drain the three like Porzingis. He takes the idea of that inside-outside threat to a whole nother level.
And so it's down, leading by a full 31 points at the end of the quarter. And it's been their rugged defense.
And then they come back.
And we'll be back with you shortly. And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. And so it's Doncic with it. He brings it up for the Dallas Mavericks. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Detroit, where they'll face the Pistons. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. And now it's shut down the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. On the floor for Dallas, Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr. Then there's Marjanovic. Now, here's Fox. Got that bucket in and no time at all. 9 points in the game so far.
He's taking what he sees out there. I love seeing Fox torch the deep in this area.
Passes it to Marjanovic. Dallas moving the ball around.
Wow, they changed the animation.
Finish the way. He's got 36.
And up the last
1% covered. What?
On the interior. This is just,
it's like my defender's not even, he doesn't exist.
Fox,
that's like me sometimes.
The wide open look here for Fox. And it's rebounded by Dallas.
He gets the playground jumper and can't make good on it. So he don't get many chances either.
Oh, he delivers that.
I can't believe it. I cannot believe that. Oh, let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
He said, let's go home.
Last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. Let's a floater go. Here's Bagley. Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
What's up? So much of rebounding is energy and effort, and Bagley plays with both.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And of course, we'd all like to see his percentage of the line improve, but he just does not have the touch right now. He's in the 60s.
On the wing, Hardaway.
Tim.
On number three for Dallas.
Hasn't taken them any time to find their rhythm in the second half. 4 for 4 from the field already.
For Sacramento, they've gone 2 of 4 here to start the
4 for 4 for Tim Hardaway. Junior.
Teardrop shot. And the rejection by Marjanovic. Down low, here's Doncic in the dunk by Doncic.
Has the vertical needed to dunk it. Doncic showing off the power and flair that he possesses.
Barnes outside. Shoots the three. It's rebounded by Dallas. Marjanovic has got his 16th rebound on the night. An absolute bomb from three-point range.
Couldn't have scripted a better start to the half. They've hit every single shot since the break.
A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Here's Spice.
Get out of here.
Deflected, and so it looks like the Kings will retain possession here. Sacramento making a switch here. Ariza's checked in. Bagley kicks to heel. 6 on the shot clock. Outside, Fox. Shot to stop. And he recovers it.
I fucked up again, but he still made the shot. Team takeover. Please don't put me on the bench again.
Yikes.
And looking at his offensive numbers from the past few years, it seems like teams around the league have kind of figured him out. He's having to work a lot harder for his points.
I couldn't even move. I'm pressing X. I couldn't even move. Did Luka just shut that out of bounds? I couldn't even move. I couldn't even just pass the ball. I was tapping X.
Do you prefer the one-handed or the two-handed champ? This year's three-point contest and how it's
I'm not even in it.
Take a look at some of the top candidates emerging as we see here some players who are likely to make the final cut.
Not too shabby of shooters on this list, Kevin. You gotta love the advancement and really the evolution of the three-point shot in today's game.
He's gonna need to leapfrog quite a few great
shots. Oh, it's our ball. My guy was out of bounds. I was getting pushed out of bounds.
I mean, anything's possible, especially if he has a few big games
from oh, all that.
Before All-Star Weekend. That give him a nice bump in the voting.
And we'll keep you posted as we find out more. And as we get closer to the three-point contest, once we have our final list of official contestants.
Yeah, it's going to be very competitive. That's the one thing we all know. We've got an incredible group of long-distance shooters.
I just split the double team.
Right, hey, whatever adjustments they made at halftime, they are working to perfection.
Well, the results are clear as day. Great approach coming into the third quarter. We'll see if they can keep it up.
Outside, Fox. Sacramento again missing.
It's been a really tough quarter for him. I mean, he cannot get his shots to drop.
The shot by Powell, no good.
Playing him tough inside and preventing the layup. That'll get the whole team pumped up.
Bagley. And
I did not get punctured.
Bagley. This is what Bagley does. I mean, he tries to get inside often and finish with this kind of force.
And the Mavericks with possession here. Pass to Porzingis. Got a piece of it.
And he got stripped. Still our ball.
Dallas will retain possession. Here's a look at the schedule now for Dallas. On Thursday, they'll be matching up with Andre Drummond.
It's not even, we don't have a good matchup until the Bucks and the Celtics, which was the last time we did lose to them.
And looking at the Bucks matchup, even though they should get the win.
Oh, it's still winning. Yes. 33% covered, and I still got the assist. It got tipped.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Outside, Fox. Deadman trying to break free. Fox, no good.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Oh, man, an awful display from him so far. But you know he's going to keep working and try to turn it around.
Doubled by Fox. And here's Porzingis for a three. Here's Powell. It's with the rebound. Deadman's got more rebounds now tonight. Outside, Fox. Healed against Hardaway. Here's Fox. Bagley trying to free himself up.
If his performance this quarter is any indication, I don't think he's the one who's going to let them out.
Double-double.
And Doncic gets it to go.
How many times
poor De'Aaron Fox.
Possession like that from them today. Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Ball's not loose. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Now they put me on the bench.
And Bagley looks to be a great. His ability to shoot and finish inside is going to make him a weapon.
And what? That one goes careening off the glass. On the court right now for the Kings.
He's still quarter even when I came in.
The two and the three. Rashawn Holmes out there with Dwayne Dedman, and it's Fox in at the guard position. And Chris, in his rookie year, Bagley needed some time to adjust.
Yeah, the Kings brought him along slowly, but about halfway through the season, he turned it off. Bagley looks like another standout player from a loaded 2018 draft class.
Four on the clock. Hardaway for three. It's Dedman with the rebound.
He's done a lot of the little things to help put them in front. I mean, but his offense has not been there for the night.
Good, and a nice assist from Fox. Deadman's got
oh my God, we're literally up by 50.
You see the evolution of Fox as a passer, and with every pass like that, it's obvious how far he's come.
Pass to Barea. And the NBA 2K League, the web, the first e-sport operated by a U.S. pro sport, and it's quickly growing. You threw down on the sticks?
Yeah, just a little announcement to all the GMs in the 2K League. I am available. I'm a free agent. I'm ready to go. I'm nice on the sticks. I can play career mode, team mode, one-on-one mode. Whatever you need from me, I am ready to go. But I love it, man.
Oh.
It's great to see people who love this game, whether it's virtual or real life. It's hoops, baby.
So much fun. Healed, can't hit. And it's Barea with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Dallas Mavericks. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points. Second chance shot.
That's a flagrant.
On the shot and sends in to the line. Okay. And that one misses. And the impact that Porzingis can have on the defensive end break cannot be overstated.
The reach and leaping ability he has paired with his timing make him a premier rim protector. And what sets him over the top really is that fearlessness. He will challenge anyone and everyone at the rim.
Porzingis against Fox.
Oh, finally he made a shot.
Fox is mastering the timing required to succeed in the pick and roll. Trust me, it's not easy.
To the inside, Barea.
Imagine Barea shot that over De'Aaron
Fox.
And Barea has literally the height disadvantage.
Healed outside. 13 feet away. That's in for his fifth field goal of the game. Makes him 5 for 12 so far.
Hill is very efficient. An incredibly versatile, talented player. Lights out score.
Kicks to Jackson. That transition from being a player to retirement can be a challenge for some. What were the keys that you found in succeeding at that?
Well, first I think it's adjusting to the fact you don't have the same schedule, you don't have a physical release that you used to have, you missed the locker room and the camaraderie with all the guys, so you miss the culture. But secondly, I would say take all the lessons that you learned, and for me this was big, from sports and use them as business. So in business, I became a rookie in other areas. I found a Chris Mullin type in business. I found the Latrell Sprewell type, guys that would mentor you, guys that you would play on their team. Humble yourself, get back to it, get to practice, get to meetings early, stay in practice late, stay at meetings to be the last one that leaves, and just take the culture of basketball, infuse that athletic personality into the personality of whatever you go into next, and you can use those tenets to have a wonderful retirement and really enjoy it. So for me, it's been awesome. And by the way, I've had twins, and so since retiring, and that'll keep you just as busy as you want to play. So you can find ways to keep that same lifestyle.
That's right. And some sound advice, too. And so here's Sacramento. Fox passes to Heal. Fox against Berea. The pass to Giles. Bucket is good. Giles has got his first bucket of the night.
Oh, that's not the kind of interior defense you want. Way too slow to protect the rim.
Shoots from the baseline.
In. Oh, in and out.
Inside, here's Ariza, banked in off the glass.
Oh, greatest comeback ever.
Ariza sticks it to the defense, out-muscling and out-working anyone in front of him.
To the middle.
Berea! Hey, he got it.
Field goal of the night. Now shooting 5-for-8.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Healed outside. Outside, Fox.
Oh, stole it.
Off target with his three. Dallas has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have gone. And it's Hardaway with the jam.
Oh, he is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think.
Not really. Have you seen the dunks I've done?
I'll heal. From 11 feet away, but shot missing.
Hasn't been able to find any kind of groove this quarter. I mean, it seems like he's been running on fumes since halftime.
The other day, Chris, I heard Commissioner Adam Silver talking about that it strikes him sometimes how isolated players can be with cell phones and headphones and those things.
Dishwasher trophy.
That you're concerned about.
My nephews and nieces.
No, even a replay for that? Come on.
Kids walking across the street looking at their phones and not even looking both ways.
Bob City Passer on Silver.
Yeah. Oh, come on. You know, Kevin, those are the times. And so I would tell Adam Silver, Mr. Commissioner, yeah, that's a basketball problem. That's a world problem. How are we going to stop any of that? We're here now. There's no putting that genie back in the bottle, Kevin.
And it's Porzingis that time on the assist by Berea. Correa's got 4 assists in the game. And here's Heald. He'll bring it up for the Kings.
Porzingis got his takeover.
Outside, Fox. It's rebounded by Dallas. Porzingis has got 14 rebounds for him tonight. Wow. Passes it to Berea. Jackson with it. And here is Hardaway. Ariza covering. Here's Porzingis.
Porzingis.
Porzingis has got 27.
27 for Porzingis.
Aggressive on him, but when you're giving up that much height, there's only so much you can do.
Shot by Heald. Nobody around. A 3-pointer off the mark.
So when the defense gets about him on the perimeter, they're playing with fire. Lucky they don't get burned here.
Outside Hardaway. Back to Porzingis. Shot clock at 6. To the paint.
Oh, first turnover.
Here we go, 1-on-1. And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. Tim Hardaway picks one up.
Oh, you love how physical Ariza is. Just attacking the D and earning the call in the process.
Free throw good from Trevor Ariza.
They literally subbed me for like 30 seconds.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. You can safely say mission accomplished now for the Mavericks.
It was a standout performance across the board.
I mean, it was like watching
a cat played with a mouse. They were able to do more or less whatever they wanted.
So looking at the season total, this will be their 17th win.
And against a conference opponent, always good to take that first win of the season series to establish a psychological edge.
Right wing. Just five to shoot. Dallas needs to get off a shot. That one trumps for it.
And credit the whole team. It was a focused, concerted effort to put this one away.
I'll try to get 50, but you know what? It's not going to be enough.
No signs of selfishness. It's just a total team effort.
Here's Bogdanovich. Off the left rim and out. Pass to Curry. So no problem for Dallas as they get the win.
Bro, we beat them. This is my highest deficit we've ever done it. This has to be. Wait, is this Hall of Fame or is this Pro difficulty? Did they 2K literally change my difficulty?
They were not going automatic. To relinquish it.
And that about wraps it up for Chris.
Check it out. Hall of Fame. Okay.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Shaquille O'Neal to my right. Kenny the Jet Smith on my left. Right here in the middle, I'm Ray Johnson. And a chance now to head down to the locker room for our post-game interview.
Hey, man, this is Kenny, man. I thought your coach did a great job on the offensive end to get you open. Getting you into a rhythm was important. What was he telling you before the game?
Just to be ready. We knew there might be some opportunities that we could exploit. My teammates worked hard to give me the shots on time, in rhythm. I appreciate the trust they had in me, man. I make the headlines, yeah, because that's a lot of points, but everyone in our family, they do their part.
They did their part, but you do get the headline, brother.
And that's a wrap, everybody. Thanks for joining us this evening. For Shaq, for the Jet, for Kevin Harlan and the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. We will see you again soon.
Well, not soon enough.
Congrats on the win, Che.
Thanks, Patty. I appreciate that.
It looked like you were really focusing on setting up your teammates tonight. Was that a point of emphasis for you, or more a matter of making the right play at the right time?
No, it's a little bit of both. I always want to get my teammates going. And if we're all getting good looks, then that means we're that much more dangerous out there. But, you know, you don't want to force things. So we were just taking what the defense gave us out there.
A good game tonight, Che. What is it about playing these guys that makes you feel so comfortable?
Hey, it's just one of those nights, baby. I got hot. Nothing anyone could do about that. Keep it coming.
You got a game against Detroit. Detroit's not doing too well, too. Yeah, Vern. Yeah, 2020 NBA champs, huh? The Pistons. And they're 12 in the East.